y'all. It's your girl, the Evelyn Chanel, and today we making popcorn rolls. But first, you got to wash your hands. And please excuse this jar right here. It has to be cleaned out for Saturday, because y'all already know it's my birthday week. And if you don't know what Saturday is, you gonna find out. So, So just to go over my ingredients and stuff, I got, of course, my big bowl, my butter, but I'm only going to use a stick with that. I got 2 bags of marshmallows, but I'm pretty sure I'm only going to need one. And then I got some sugar babies and some M&Ms. Then I got my popcorn, of course, because you can't make popcorn balls without the popcorn. And I got my pot. And I got something just to put the popcorn balls on. And then, hold on. There it is. I got some non-stick cooking spray, so. And I thought about doing like kettle popcorn, well, not kettle popcorn, but the popcorn where you pop it on the stove yourself. But I don't know what it said. I had some. But it might have got lost in transition. Oh, that's because you want to stay down here with me. If y'all want a video or what I'm gonna put in this jar, then let me know now. Cause I've already started prepping the stuff for it. But yeah, I'm excited. I am excited.
So excited! So excited!
About my birthday. Excuse the cheek of my told me that we had cheek. Chicken and green beans and stuff early. I'm not my boyfriend got me some rolls. Not the rolls, but the biscuits. Y'all know the honey biscuits that you can get from like the corner store? Like, I'm in love with those. But I was dreaming about them last night. And he got me some. Excuse me. I'm the type that I always get those rolls. I like to be comfortable, I'm sorry. Dude, that smells so good. Popcorn. Smells just wonderful. Marvelous. And I know I be doing stuff and I don't be like getting no like close up so y'all can see. I just be trying to get like a general look and walk out through the process. And I'm sorry. I'm sorry about that, but the thing about it is, I don't have no actual camera. So I can't just be like, because you know, I found out that you flip the camera around when you record. So, yeah. One of these days, and maybe somewhere I'll be able to, you know, get a close up look for y'all. But we'll figure something out until then. Y'all, I thought my phone was going off and I was like, I know. I put y'all on do not disturb. So I don't understand why I'm getting calls. I was just taking my hand.
Marshmallows.
when to slow down, like the pop slide. Yeah, but I ain't catching this time.
Ooh, steaming hot.
I was gonna get the Reese's Pieces, but for some reason, the Dollar General I was in was out of Reese's Pieces. Like, I wanted to get like, what you call them? Boston Butt, the candy. Y'all know what I'm talking about? Like the candy peanuts. I wanted to get those, but I didn't see any of those. So I got these instead. And these really, I'm gonna eat everything that I open, y'all. God, dog. Anyway, hurry up, bro. I eat all my own ingredients. Y'all know what it says. I'm pretty sure this is what I'm just going to do with other people. My boyfriend was supposed to do it with me, but he still got pins in his hands when his hair is drying, so I'm just not gonna embarrass me that much. Cause that's not cute. But you wanna melt your butter down, all of that. I'm making the popcorn balls, but my boyfriend owed me some Rice Krispie treats because, like, he was making Rice Krispie treats and they just be so good to my spirit. So, like, he really owed me some Rice Krispie treats, y'all. If y'all want to see a video of me doing it with him, let me know. Usually, I just go to Walmart and buy the little popcorn balls they have, like, around. Should have got me some candy corn. It would have been just what the doctor ordered. I love candy corn. I'm one of those people. Candy corn. It's fine. We just go to the store and I make it, make me some Rice Krispie treats and I put candy corn in them. That's what we do. Yeah, I decided that's what we're doing. Yeah, see, I say it pays, but that's not what I meant. I'm sorry. Don't listen to me. Just watch me. But you want to get it to me. They all melt together. But you don't want to burn them, so be careful. And I actually got it on 3. So, yeah. If that helps any, my living is on 3. The 1 being the lowest, 9 being the highest. And it doesn't have orange in there, so I guess we're gonna do, we're gonna mix yellow and red. And we're gonna get orange. Y'all follow me? But you wanna do this probably quicker than what I did. That way, you know. trying to spray the inside of the dog on the sink. But you up there playing the game? You're going to need to, if you're doing it by yourself, you're going to do it more than often. You're going to need to continue to put some of your hands and stuff to keep the stuff from sticking to you, is what I'm trying to say. And you have to be a little rough, like, even though you might be like me and you don't want to crush up your candy, you'll have to be a little rough, because if you don't push them together, then they're gonna fall apart. So yeah, it's okay to be a little rough sometimes. It's okay to be a little rough sometimes. And what I'm doing is I'm squishing them together and then putting them in the refrigerator. So.
Not the freezer.
The Frigidaire. Tell y'all, so from my experience, one things you need to know is you're gonna have to repeatedly spray your hands, because you got to make sure you know it's sticky at all times. Two, if you want to do two different candies and somebody doesn't want one type of candy and other people don't care, then you want to put it in two separate bowls, that way you can mix it together. And then you know, Add the marshmallow to it. So you want to do that in two different bowls, so that it's already sticky. If you are wrapping them up for treats, then I would say as soon as you get done, because mine ain't in the refrigerator right now. As soon as you get done making the balls, just go ahead and drop them in the bag. So whatever that may look like, you may need some help, but go ahead and drop them in the bag. That way, it'll hold the shape better. And if you're doing it in treats, you gotta drop in the bag, you need somebody on standby to close the bag for you. Your hands gonna be a little messy. I feel like it was kind of getting hot, which is why mine was starting to fall apart. So what I did was I sat in the refrigerator as I made them. And for the most part, they're holding good now. So, yeah. And remember that I did have candy. And of course, when you have it, like right now, you'll have more of the marshmallow. When you pour it on it like I did, I'm pretty sure you know it's gone, even if you dump it in there. I mean, if you dump the popcorn in the bowl that has the stuff on it. The bowl that has, if you dump the bowl of popcorn into the pan with your marshmallow, give me some marshmallows, I'm pretty sure you'll still have the same. Y'all, I dyed my hands orange. You'll still have the same struggle. But try to mix it up as best as you can. It actually might work better, but I don't have a pot like that. It's deep enough if you pour it in a longer pot. And then you can just, you know, take the popcorn and do like that with it. This one I had a certain, you know, amount of room, so I used a spoon. can really like dig in like I wanted to. So yeah, that's just a few things. We're gonna let those sit for a couple of minutes. And then I'm gonna show y'all what they're looking like. I'm a little impatient, so I'm gonna let the rest of them sit there, but I'm gonna go ahead and try this one. So first, I'm gonna let, ooh. That's good. It's good.
Much, much, much later.
I forgot y'all was still here. Let me cut it off. For real. All right, you guys. I'm gonna go. This is really good. Really good.